SEC has always been a defense-first kind of league. Back in the 1950s, when a different league team was making a national title run each year, it was always based around dominant D. Auburn allowed 28 total points in an unbeaten 1957 run. Ole Miss allowed 21 points in 1959. Alabama allowed 25 points in 1961, etc. Defense is in the DNA, but points aren't a bad thing, nor is adapting with the times. The SEC technically still grades out as the nation's best conference on average this season, but after enjoying a massive advantage as recently as 2 or 3 years ago, the advantage has shrunk quickly, if not disappeared altogether. While the ACC has upgraded its coaching roster significantly, adding Mark Richt, Bobby Petrino, Justin Fuente, Dave Clawson, Bronco Mendenhall, and others within the last few years, the SEC has been a little bit more predictable. From 2013 to 16, the league hired 9 new head coaches. 6 of them came from the defensive side. Of the 4 hires made in 2015-16, 3 had Nick Saban ties. To a degree, those hires worked out. Georgia's Kirby Smart appears to be the one former Saban assistant who has flashed a Saban-level ceiling. Florida Jim McElwain managed to snag 2 division titles before flaming out. And while South Carolina's Will Muschamp champ isn't putting an aesthetically pleasing team on the field, he's 8-4. You might need to figure out a different path. So far, so good. At least 6 league teams are replacing head coaches: Arkansas, Florida, Mississippi State, Ole Miss, Tennessee, and Texas A&M, and the first 3 to make their choices have all gone after offensive guys. For all we know, the other 3 league schools could still skew toward defense. Tennessee, after all, tried to sign Ohio State defensive coordinator Greg Schiano before unsuccessfully going after offense-friendly Oklahoma State head coach Mike Gundy on Tuesday. The next options on the list appear to be offensive guys, at least. And who the hell knows what Arkansas is going to do? Arkansas doesn't, therefore we don't. First, he comes from outside the league. A few outside influences aren't a bad thing. We don't know anything about the staff he will put together or how he will establish ties in a new recruiting area, but the organic growth of his offensive system has been startling. The first time Moorhead was officially in charge of an offense, he raised Georgetown's scoring average from 17.4 points per game to 22.6 in 2003. He ended up on Rob Brookhart's staff at Akron, and in 3 years, the Zipsoff S&P Plus ranking rose from 100th to 55th. His first year as Randy Edsall's coordinator at UConn, 2009, produced a 6-point improvement and no 31 ranking in off S&P Plus. He became Fordham head coach in 2012, and after a 6-5 debut, the Rams took off. They went 32-8.